Welcome to my channel. My name is Nurse Pauline RN. I will be uploading my videos on Tuesdays and Thursdays, Eastern Standard Time. Thank you for watching my channel today. Thanks to all my subscribers and to all the people who are commenting. I appreciate it. The goal of my channel is to assist students to pass their fundamentals of nursing exam. Before I get started, I'm going to ask you to hit your like button, hit your subscribe button, please. The topic today is planning, intervention, and evaluation. In planning, we're planning priorities of care, Maslow hierarchy of needs, human needs, physiological needs. We're planning ABCs, diagnostics, planning and goal are almost the same. You're planning care, you're planning outcomes to be achieved. Prioritizing nursing diagnosis, identify measurable goals or outcomes, selecting appropriate interventions, and documenting plan of care. Implementation is performing care, document response to care. We implement our assessments. Objectives or subjective. Nursing interventions are implemented to meet the needs of your patient. That means the type of care, the time of care, and we need the signature of the nurse who took care of our patients. Interventions assist the patient to achieve outcomes. Interventions are based on specific rationales. We have nursing intervention books from your NIC. It's called Nursing Intervention Classification Book. And these books assist you with your nursing interventions. Nursing interventions and nursing actions to achieve an outcome. We have a lot of work to do and we have a lot of interventions. Okay, our intervention examples are our diet. Is your patient NPO? Is your patient on a liquid diet? Is your patient on a regular diet? We do interventions by doing exercises, range of motion exercises, ambulating our patients. PT and OT can assist us with the patients. Speech therapists will do swallow evaluation for patients who are unable to swallow maybe their medications. Post-op patients, we encourage them to use their incentive spirometers. We assess their wounds and drains. We ambulate these patients, and these patients are on strict INO. Urine output should be greater than 30 cc's an hour. For post-op patient, make sure the nurse or the LPN is taking care of the patient's output from drains and maybe Foley catheters. Do not wait until the end of the shift. Assess your output drains, your colostomy, your ileostomy, your wound vac drainage, your chest tube drainage. Assess all your drains on the hour or every 2 hours. Make sure your patients are voiding post-op. Strict I's and O's on all your IV fluids, on your antibiotics. Some patients receive TPN, tube feeding, parenteral nutrition. Some people and receives two feeding from their G-tubes. We need teaching education for your patients. We need return demonstration. For example, administering insulins. Make sure they understand. We need return demonstrations from patients and families. Patients weren't able to do it when they go home. We may have to draw blood. And if the HNH is low, we may have to administer blood for your patients. We have to maintain precautions, four precautions, aspiration precautions, isolation, seizure precautions, safety precautions, infection control, hand washing, that's safety. Interventions for sitters. Is your patient safe when you turn your back? You have bed alarm, chair alarms, but patient may need one and one sitter. Patient may need restraint orders, documentation every 2 hours, restraints to be renewed every 24 hours. We need to make sure patients have their allergy bracelets. Some patients are on seizure precaution. Some patients are on alcoholic withdrawal precautions. Assess these patients for safety. Don't forget, reorient the elderly to person, place, time, and situation. Keep reorienting the elderly because they are in strange places. Sometimes they're not aware that they're in the hospital. IV fluids, intake and output. We may have to replace potassium, magnesium supplements, calcium supplements. Most of all, we have to develop, most important with intervention, we develop a therapeutic relationship with our patients. Okay, our outcomes should be set and fixed and timely and measurable, appropriate, realistic. Expected outcomes are long-term or short-term. Example of a short-term. You're going to get up this elderly patient. You're going to check her vital signs. Make sure she's stable. You sit her in a chair. And by midday, you're going to go back, check her vital signs. Make sure oxygen is greater than 92. If it's not, if she needs oxygen, you get an ambulatory oxygen machine. Walk with her walker. Or cane, you may need your tech to walk one on the right, you're on the left, two people walking this patient to the door and back, then sit her back in the chair. Don't encourage your patients to be in bed. We need them to expand their lungs, sitting in the chair and moving around. That's a short-term goal, and that was for noon. We may extend our outcomes that at 6 p.m. we're gonna go back and walk this patient. You're gonna check her vital signs, check her oxygen. She may not need oxygen because she's up like 6 hours moving around. She's stable. But if she do need her oxygen, get a ambulatory oxygen machine and ambulator with the oxygen. The walker, we don't want to encourage patients using oxygen, so keep them moving. We don't want them to go home with oxygen. From the door, you're going to walk her along the hallway. We are going to see how well she do at the hallway, and sometimes you can do a walking pulse ox on her if the doctor orders it. Usually the doctor orders a walking pulse ox for your patients for them to go home with or without oxygen. If they're not able to maintain their goal, this patient will have to go home on oxygen. Some patients are not able to do their wound care, their outcome is not met. We will talk with the social worker. She'll arrange for a visiting nurse to go to the home to do their dressing change. Some patients' outcome are not met. They're not able to go home. They have to go to rehab. evaluate your goals. The evaluation phase of the nursing process, the nurse judges that the evaluation is achieved and the stated outcome. I have a nursing diagnosis here, and this one is for pneumonia. The name of the diagnosis should be linked to the etiology, which is the cause of the diagnosis, with the phrase related to, which are your objectives, what you see related to, as evidenced by what you can see. The name of the diagnosis for pneumonia, when I looked into my nurse's diagnosis book, pneumonia is a medical diagnosis by the doctor. The nurse's diagnosis in the diagnosis book is ineffective airway clearance. Ineffective airway clearance. The airway is not patent. What's causing it? What is it related to? The cause of this ineffective airway clearance is excessive secretions, ineffective cough, pleuritic pain. The patient is not able to expand her lungs. She has increased sputum. There's inflammation. And there is also aspiration going on with this patient. So these are the causes that is causing this ineffective airway clearance. So you check your nurse's diagnosis and you see the diagnosis, you see the relationship. They'll tell you a lot of things that ineffective relationship is related to. And then we have all these causes as evidence to what you see, as evidence to your objectives, as evidence to changes in respiration rate and depth, as evidence to what I'm looking at or listening to, abnormal breath sound. These are your objectives. As evidence to use of accessory muscles, dyspnea, cyanosis, I can see these. Decreased breath sounds, dyspnea, these are all your objective. So your nurse's diagnosis is in your nurse's diagnosis for that medical diagnosis, which only the doctor does, which is pneumonia. So your nurse's diagnosis, ineffective airway clearance, is caused by, is related to, as evidence to what I see, which is my objective. Thanks, guys. Hit your like buttons.